Dina, could you tell us a bit about your own experiences in blogging?
Blogging has changed my world personally. Before I started my first blog in 2003. Before that, I'm a qualitative researcher and an ethnographer, and I've been working on my own for a long time. So what blogging enabled me to do is build communities of interest around certain, you know, areas of interest.
I think you'll have very interesting experiences, particularly in responding to the tsunami and the Bombay terror attacks.
Yeah.
Could you tell us?
The tsunami's case is well documented, actually.
Yeah. And Peter Griffin's article.
But
for people who might not know it, briefly.
I've also written about it. But what happened with the tsunamis is, I think there was an outpouring of this feeling that you wanted to do something, but you couldn't all just get up and go to the regions which were being affected. So what can we do online? So Peter mobilized an early set of three of us to set up a blog and start bringing out the word in terms of not just the news, but in terms of actually what people are needing, and linking it back with the resources that you wanted.
This was December 2004.
December 2000.
Roughly which date? 24th was the tsunami.
We set it up the same day.
26th.
That the news came out. 26th. And we had about over a million hits in about 8 days. But the point that was really interesting about it is, because there was a space which was an easy space to get into, the entry barriers were very low.
So a whole lot of others also joined.
A whole lot of others. There were about 150 odd people working the blog.
From all over the region.
Absolutely. Not just the region, the world.
Yeah.
We had people from the United States helping out and everywhere. And the beauty was that the Blogspot blog was very simple to actually get even new people who haven't ever blogged earlier into the fold. And when we realized, at that time at least, Blogspot did not have categories, so the data was getting lost.
Yeah.
So we set up a wiki to actually classify all the data that we were collecting, and actually help people who network, those between those who had help to offer and those who needed the help. So it was completely decentralized. There isn't even today. I mean, though after the tsunamis, when Katrina struck in New Orleans and the south of...
The same model was used in many other places.
Similar models were used. Even with Gustav, we lent our hand and tried to do what we could do to help mobilize people to connect better in terms of relieving some of the victims.
And then the Bombay terror?
That was interesting, because that whole thing sort of blew up in the blogosphere through Twitter, and which is a microblogging platform where you can only put 140 characters into your message. But some of us had large Twitter communities, and we were just updating from our living rooms, because many of us were not on the ground. But there were some people who were also on the ground who were putting up videos and, you know, pictures on Flickr and YouTube and stuff like that. And what happened with Twitter was very interesting, because Twitter enables you to set up a search with a hashtag against a keyword.
Yeah.
So the hashtag was Mumbai terror.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that served as a huge source of first-hand information about what is going on the ground. Much of it came from mainstream media, what we were seeing on television. So we have to give credit to that.
So you'll be amplifying it and taking it.
Amplifying it and retweeting it and moving it forward virally. So much so that a lot of the international mainstream media, including the CNN and BBC and many, many, many others, actually use this stream that was evolving on Twitter as their source of information about what was going on the ground.
So from here, what are your plans next?
You know, I'm what you call an accidental activist.
Yeah.
It's not my main job. It's not what I do for a living.
But you enjoy it.
But it's something I'm passionate about. I'm passionate about using these tools and finding new ways of it, making a real impact.
Do enough people use it in India? Are blogs pretty common here?
Blogs are getting more and more common. It's becoming part of the vocabulary that even mainstream media